Welcome back, stargazers. In our last journey through the universe, we delved into the wonders of Messier objects 34 through 44, exploring everything from the rich clusters in Auriga to the dazzling Beehive Cluster. If you missed that episode, be sure to check it out and join us as we continue our cosmic adventure. Today, we're picking up right where we left off. From the brilliant stars of the Pleiades to the ancient globular clusters that orbit our galaxy, we're diving into Messier objects 45 through 55. Get ready to uncover more secrets of our amazing universe. But before we begin, if you are new here, don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Our first stop is Messier 45, the famous Pleiades, an open cluster in the constellation Taurus, about 444 light-years from Earth. Also known as the Seven Sisters, this cluster contains hundreds of stars, with the most prominent ones being bright blue giants. Visible to the naked eye, the Pleiades is a stunning sight, especially through binoculars. The cluster is also notable for its reflection nebulae, caused by dust reflecting the blue light of the hot, young stars. Next, we move on to Messier 46, an open cluster in the constellation Puppis, roughly 5,400 light-years away. M46 is a rich cluster containing around 500 stars. What makes it even more interesting is the planetary nebula, NGC 2438, superimposed on the cluster, adding a fascinating detail to your telescope view. This nebula is not physically part of the cluster, but is instead a foreground object. Continuing our journey, we find Messier 47, another open cluster in Puppis, approximately 1,600 light-years from Earth. M47 is relatively close and features bright, scattered stars. This cluster contains about 50 stars, including some red giants, making it a delightful target for stargazers. It is more loosely bound than M46 and has a distinctive, bright appearance. Our next destination is Messier 48, an open cluster in the constellation Hydra. Located around 1,500 light-years away, M48 contains about 80 stars spread across a wide area. Visible to the naked eye under good conditions, this cluster presents a beautiful, sparkling view through binoculars or a small telescope. Its stars range from magnitudes 8 to 13, making it a relatively easy cluster to observe. Shifting our gaze, we encounter Messier 49, an elliptical galaxy in the constellation Virgo, approximately 56 million light-years away. M49 is one of the brightest galaxies in the Virgo cluster, with a massive elliptical shape and numerous globular clusters surrounding it. It's a fascinating object to observe with a larger telescope. M49 also houses a supermassive black hole at its center and has been the site of several supernova. Next, we visit Messier 50, an open cluster in the constellation Monoceros, about 3,200 light-years from Earth. M50 is a moderately rich cluster with around 200 stars. Its heart-shaped arrangement of stars makes it an intriguing and picturesque object to observe. The cluster includes several red giants and is about 140 million years old. Continuing our exploration, we come upon Messier 51, the famous whirlpool galaxy in the constellation Canes Venetici. Located about 23 million light-years away, M51 is a stunning spiral galaxy with well-defined arms. It interacts with a smaller galaxy, NGC 5195, creating a striking visual pairing for observers. The Whirlpool Galaxy is a classic example of a grand design spiral galaxy and is undergoing a tidal interaction that has sparked intense star formation. Next, we arrive at Messier 52, an open cluster in the constellation Cassiopeia, roughly 4,600 light-years away. M52 is a rich and young cluster containing about 200 stars. Its dense star field makes it a spectacular sight through a telescope, especially in the dark skies of winter. The cluster is embedded in a rich Milky Way star field and has an age of about 35 million years. Our journey now takes us to Messier 53, a globular cluster in the constellation Coma Berenices, approximately 58,000 light-years away. M53 is densely packed with hundreds of thousands of stars and is one of the more distant globular clusters from the galactic center. It's a beautiful object to observe through a telescope. M53 is one of the few globular clusters that show evidence of having a significant population of blue stragglers. Next, we visit Messier 54, another globular cluster, this time in the constellation Sagittarius. Located about 87,000 light-years away, M54 is notable for being one of the first extragalactic globular clusters discovered, as it belongs to the Sagittarius dwarf elliptical galaxy. Its densely packed stars offer a magnificent view through larger telescopes. M54 has a very dense core and is home to an intermediate mass black hole. Our final stop in this episode is Messier 55, a globular cluster in Sagittarius, roughly 17,600 light-years from Earth. M55 is relatively loose compared to other globular clusters, with around 100,000 stars. It's easy to resolve into individual stars with a moderate-sized telescope, making it a rewarding object for amateur astronomers. M55 lacks a dense core and has a slightly elliptical shape. As we wrap up this fifth episode of Messier Objects, how many of the 11 discussed in this video did you recognize? Let us know in the comments below. Join us in further episodes as we continue to unravel the secrets of the cosmos, one Messier object at a time. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more fascinating content, and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Until next time, keep looking up and exploring the cosmos.